Hey guys, what is going on? This is Ip of Rage Quit TV, gonna be casting the Aces Republic of Gamers, group number two. This is a BO5 between Millennium 4GG and Fnatic Moon, a ZVT on Cloud Kingdom. And generally, what happens on this map is a lot of Terran players go on three bases really quick because, well, it is so hard to engage Terran on this map. And additionally, if you do any type of two base timing attacks, there's always this one Overlord up here that's gonna be seeing it coming, which means a lot of those two base timing attacks just aren't effective. It is a really long map. A lot of Zergs will just get the perfect defense when you try to move out. And Moon is one of those Zerg players who's become really good when he first entered StarCraft 2. A lot of people expected him just be amazing, but he tried playing StarCraft 2 and Warcraft 3 both competitively at the same time, which just didn't work out. But fairly recently, he has switched to StarCraft 2 full time and just has become really good. A lot of players just don't give this guy enough credit. We'll be seeing exactly what he ends up doing. He is more of an aggressive player, but for GG, he is relatively aggressive as well. When he started going StarCraft 2, he just did all sorts of just timing attacks, really cheesy play, but lately he has tried to work on his macro a little bit, and well, he is a really scary Terran player. We do have him just getting the barracks right at 12 supply, which just means he's not going to go command center first, which a lot of Terran players will just blindly do on maps like Cloud Kingdom, where it's really hard to just punish that. We will have Moon go for a 15 hatch, and well, command center first just overall is really hard to punish lately. So a lot of Terran players kind of favor going with that after Marine King Prime and Tasia have made that so popular. We will be seeing if Moon ends up getting gas. Most likely this is going to be a one racks fast expand. As I did say, a lot of Terran players really do like going on three bases. And Moon, we'll see when he ends up getting his third base. That first Overlord is going to be getting into position. And one thing to note is Moon is not doing any type of drone scout. If he does this several times in this series, then for GG, he's going to just go for two racks. Because if you do a two racks and they don't drone scout, it is almost a free win. It's so hard to stop. And here we go, the one racks fast expo coming out from 4GG. I don't know if it's fast anymore now that the command center first has become relatively popular. We do see the second Overlord going down in the southern position, just all the way down here. Since 4GG not going to scout this area, there's no harm in sending this Overlord down here. There may be a small timing if this Marine went off over here. He could pick it off, but there's not any chance of him knowing the Overlord's in this position. We can see it has avoided all sorts of detection. Doesn't even go directly from his hatch down here. He went over to the side then down so he could avoid the watchtowers just in case an SCV did go take them, see the Overlord, and then a Marine could go and pick it on off. We do have the gas for Moon before he ends up taking his third base, so he will be getting a relatively early speed, which can shut down a lot of just mass Marine builds, because Marines against Speedlings, not so good until they get Stim and Medivacs. 4GG just be taking down this one supply depot while getting a bunker, and of course Moon does have the one Overlord up here, so he can see whatever 4GG decides to move out. We do have the factory going down, and a little bit interesting, he is getting double gases right now, and that is relatively early. Just saying, well, he wants to take a third base so early. If he wanted to do that, I wouldn't expect him to get these gases at the same exact time. You can see 2400, 2400 on both of those, so those were at the same time. This one Overlord murking his way over to 4GG's base, and that will be able to see this double gas. And as I did click on them, show they were at the same time, it's going to be really easy for Moon to know exactly what is up. And I think I call this 4GG's Overlord. It's definitely Moon's Overlord. We do have Moon going to be taking both of these wires. Towers right now with his Lings, does have speed on the way, and is he going to be taking his third base? It is 5 minutes and 30 seconds in the game, and he doesn't have a third hatch just yet. Going to be starting to get that creep, and there we go, that drone is going to be making his way on over, hopefully going to be building that third base. But we do have Banshees coming along with this one barracks with the tech lab, so it looks like it is going to be cloaked Banshees along with these reactored Hellions. And this one Overlord, we'll see if he actually gets a scout on that gas. It looks like he may just be stopping. And this could actually be a really strong build just because Moon doesn't have any detection in this area, which means if those Banshees end up taking the perfect path, Moon just will not see it. Actually, he's going to kill these Lings with the Hellions, eliminating the vision of the middle of the map, which means these Banshees are going to go relatively unscouted, which is going to give Moon a lot of trouble. As the Hellions do come in now, the last Ling does go down. Moon's vision is pretty grim, but that one Overlord is going to come in. We'll see this double gas, knows there's no third base, so How is Moon gonna prepare against this? This one Overlord may want to move in, see what's in the bunker. Not seeing any units inside this bunker, that'd be a huge thing. Saying, well, there's only three Marines out on the field. What are you doing? Those Hellions do make the way up. Two Queens over here to try to deny it. And these Hellions probably not going to do the most damage. This Queen will have a transfuse. Just me poking these Hellions. Nice micro gain that one very injured Hellion back. And the Queen going to be going back. Will a transfuse come down? No! 48 energy. Did not have enough. Just barely missed the timing for that transfuse. Now a Banshee is going to come out. But 4GG flies it right past Moon's Overlord. That must be a mistake. I don't know why he'd be doing that. Wants to get over there as soon as possible. But it would have been so much more deadly if he just went around. Did the Overlord see that? No. Did not see anything. Just saw those Marines. Of course, Moon may have known it was coming. But I don't believe he exactly knew. For positive, it was Banshees. Especially cloaked Banshees. Hellions with this one. Banshee are going to come. This can do a lot of damage to Moon. Doesn't really have the anti-air to deal with this. Those Hellions doing a lot of damage to those Queens. The Banshee does cloak. And this is going to spell a lot of trouble right now for Moon as that one Spine Crawler is going to go down. This hatch is going to be falling as well. We do have a Nidus Worm right now for Moon, but what can he do against this? The Banshee number is going to get relatively high. He does have a lair, but he's not building a spire or a hydra den, so his anti-air is spore crawlers and queens, which once the banshee count gets up to like beyond four, then they're just gonna pretty much two volley queens and they're not gonna do a thing against this, especially with all the hellions right here. It doesn't have the roach count right yet to deal with all these hellions, and the roach count, he's gonna need to get that relatively high because that is a lot of hellions that can do a surprising amount of damage to those roaches because they kind of have an AoE effect. So if it's like even roaches versus even hellions, I don't think it's gonna be a good trade for Moon. He needs to get something up, maybe get some type of SimCity, put the Evo Chambers down here. He's gonna be putting his macro hatch back there, but that may have been better off right over here and try to eliminate the passage of the hellions. We'll see exactly what ends up happening though. A few roaches are going to engage these hellions, and the hellions could easily just turn around and kill those roaches, but the banshee is going to come down. And stepping up, a scan does go down. I'm not exactly sure what he is scanning for, but we can see, just see how quickly those roaches are falling. Hellions decide they don't want to engage. There is no overseer, so those banshees just going to be picking off the queen. This one, full HP queen, did not want to go for it because, well, that is two banshees versus one queen, and that is not a good trade at all. Spine Crawler going to be taken out by these banshees. 4GG has just done so much damage right here. And that macro hatch now just about complete. We can see Moon really high on minerals because he is not really getting the energy to he is doing a good job injecting, I guess, just because he can't get his third base up. That is why he has this natural going up. And maybe the queens have been out and missed injects that way because they've been having used his queens for defense. Banshees are going to come in. Does go back by a spore call where he does have detection. There's also the Overseer back here. Will he be getting engaged in the Banshees? Looks like yes, he will. That one Banshee so close. Does go down. Does not transfuse the other one. Neither Queen had energy. 4GG targeting the Queens with most energy. And now getting another one really low in life. These Hellions just going to be backing on off. He may be able to engage. Well, that is a lot of roaches, so maybe he can engage. We do have a Nidus Network going up for Moon right now. And looks like maybe he's just going to say, you know what, screw it, I'm going to be doing a base trade. If you have all those Hellions and Banshees at my base, chances of your defense at your base is minimal. But 4GG does have a lot of Marines with that stim, no medivacs, so we'll see exactly how the Roaches do. Roaches generally don't do that well against stim Marines, but that is going to be 27 Roaches to, well, 31 Marines. So they do have that army supply advantage, but 4GG will have defender's advantage. That one Banshee does get away, allowing these other two to pick off that one queen. And so many drones are going down. The Nidus Worm is being built down here by the third base. And that is a lot of Hellions as well. I don't think that Moon has a chance of breaking this. 4GG, of course, probably did. No, he didn't scout that Nidus Network. Just put all his Hellions back, having the idea this type of thing could come. Great game sense. Did hear the Nidus sound once it did erupt, and now here we go. And there are changelings with this army, so Moon knows exactly what he is up against. We're going to go look at this and watch all the Roaches' HP just drop as the Hellions do the AoE. And Marines, of course, in the back, but the Roaches getting weakened up so much. The Marines' DPS in the back going to be cleaning them up, and it doesn't look like there is enough. A second stim, it looks like, going down from those Marines. No, that wasn't a second stim. Just saving that, stimming the first group of units, and then the second. GG calls out Moon. So, 4GG will be taking game number one, and unfortunately, we don't have SC2 Gears analysis in these games. We will be... I'll show you guys exactly what happens when I try loading it up. Parsing error. Not exactly sure why, so I can't open up SC2 Gears. We will look back in that battle, see if he actually did stim, like, his Marines separate times, just stimming the first group and then the second, since the second group couldn't hit. That would have been a really nice call on 4GG's part, but the analysis is going to be pretty minimal. Number one, because of that SC2 Gears being gone. And number two, wouldn't you have it, my AC died yet again. If we go over to this, you can see right now I'm at 85 degrees, so not the coolest. And that is my thermostat downstairs. So, of course, in my room, it's probably around 92, I would guess. So, not the best casting conditions, but I will be getting these games out regardless. So, you can see right now, after game number one, maybe you can see the sweat, maybe you can't. But let's look at that one battle real quick. We'll just look at this one battle slowly. Maybe he saw the roaches just disappear, and that's what prompted him to go back, but we'll see. Watching the stims. Yeah. Oh, no, he does do a full stim, and then he'll do a second stim on these units. So, not as good as I thought. I thought two stims would just take you deeper into, like, the orange. I didn't think he'd still be yellow, so that's where that small mistake comes from. But, yeah, that was pretty much it. I don't know what else I can really show about that game. Because, well, it was relatively short, and without SC2 Gears, it's really hard to see if Moon was missing injects without being really, really boring. So, we will be hopping over into game number two. Again, 4GG, one game one. This is a best of five, so enjoy, guys.